In 2018, Affiance Group Corporation, an Australian company, in partnership with Saisi State Farm, preserved part of the entrenchments used by the Allied forces during the Battle of Saisi. The Battle of Saisi was a major battle that defined World War I in northern Rhodesia, now Zambia. A monument has been erected in honor of the soldiers, both Europeans and Africans, who died during this battle, which lasted about 3 months in 1915. Today, the trenches and a park are now open to the public to experience this important part of history. Northern Rhodesia, now named Zambia, was formed in 1911 as an administered territory by the amalgamation of the two territories of northwestern and northeastern Rhodesia. However, northern Rhodesia was not administered by Britain, but by the private British South Africa Company, as was southern Rhodesia, now named Zimbabwe. But there was a difference in the way that the northern and southern Rhodesias were governed. Southern Rhodesia had a much larger white population whose interests were represented on a legislative council that could promote ordinances which became law if the British High Commissioner for South Africa assented. In northern Rhodesia, legislation was embodied in proclamations, as it was in the native protectorates, as they were then called, of Swaziland, Bechuanaland, now named Botswana, and Basotoland, now named Lesotho. A British resident commissioner for both Rhodesias represented the High Commissioner in South Africa and the Imperial Government in London, and worked alongside the British South Africa Company's administrators. The British South Africa Company was not permitted to form armies, and so it raised two police forces that were capable of limited military actions. In southern Rhodesia, the force was titled the British South Africa Police, or BSAP, and in northern Rhodesia, the title was a more straightforward one, the Northern Rhodesia Police, or NRP. A German standoff attack on Fife Fort, now Nokonde, was mounted on 6th December 1914, using around 250 men, a 3-pounder gun, and 3 machine guns. The gun fired 80 shells from a range of 1,800 meters, and half of the shells landed on the fort or in the compound. The enemy then withdrew, having killed 102 Private Indorama, NRP, who was directly hit by a shell. Exactly 3 weeks later, the Germans approached Fife again, and the NRP reacted swiftly. Lieutenant Cussins and temporary 2nd Lieutenant R.M. Smith led half the company out at 22 hours onto the previously held enemy position on the West Ridge. Contact was made on the crest and fire exchanged for 15 minutes. Then, seeing that he was about to be outflanked, Cussins led a bayonet charge straight into the enemy ranks. The German troops withdrew in disorder, leaving one Askari dead and another taken prisoner. In mid-February 1915, the White Volunteer Unit, Northern Rhodesia Rifles, NRR, Mobile Column, arrived at Fife. During early 1915, von Leto Vorbeck organized a rapid expansion of the Sutsch troop, and new units began to appear in the southwest of GEA. On the Allied side, it had been agreed that the Belgian troops in northern Rhodesia came under the command of the senior British officer in the area, and the Belgians enthusiastically participated in joint operations with the NRP to unsettle the enemy. In late February 1915, McCarthy, with an NRP patrol, killed one Rugaruga and captured 11 others. 3 weeks later, on the 17th of March, he was camped on the Samfu River near the border, along with 61 Belgian Askari, 2 European, and 4 African NRP soldiers, when a German force of 5 Europeans and 150 Askari attacked the camp. The Allies beat off the attack, capturing one enemy European and killing another, and also killing 3 Askari. The Belgians lost 3 Askari. Private W. Bacon, NRP, was also killed. The captured German officer was the commander of the Bismarckburg Police, Reserve Lieutenant Hahn, and he was severely wounded. After Hahn's capture, Bismarckburg was reinforced by a platoon of the German 10th Field Company, which was enlarged with recruits until 26th May, it became the 29th Field Company. The distance between the Abercorn and Fife garrisons was about 150 kilometers, and the British decided to construct another fortified post in between the two towns. This was necessary to prevent infiltration by Rugaruga groups who attacked the villages in the area. A location was chosen on a rocky knoll in between the rivers Saisi and Mbala. The English name for the location was Saisi, but to the Germans, it was Jericho Farm. The new post overlooked the river crossings used by the Stevenson Road that linked lakes Tanganyika and Nyasa. The farmhouse was converted into a strong fort that was surrounded by a ring of trenches. Colonel Hodson, NRP, was the first post commander, and he led over 430 Allied troops, including 214 officers and men from the NRP, 14 European volunteers of the NRR, a BSAP detachment manning a 7-pounder muzzle-loading machine gun, 206 officers and men of the 1st Belgian Battalion, one Belgian 4.7-meter Nordenfeldt gun, and three machine guns, two British and one Belgian. Hodson deployed his troops on patrols on and across the border and had several successful contacts, which obviously more than irritated the enemy. On 28 June 1915, the German 24th and 29th Field Companies, supported by a field gun and 100 Ruga Ruga Irregulars, took advantage of the early morning mist and surrounded Saisi. The enemy used their field gun, skirmished with the British outer defenses, and then withdrew after dusk. A serious attack was not delivered, as it was realized that more guns were needed to reduce the fortifications. Enemy casualties were listed as 3 Germans and 4 of their Askari, and 2 Germans and 22 Askari wounded. The Belgians had 6 Askari wounded. One Northern Rhodesia Rifleman, 121 David Alexander Wood, was killed, and 3 NRP Privates, 559 Buleya, 1184 Msapenda, and 842 Mulundi, were also killed or died of wounds. Captain J.J. O'Sullivan followed up the enemy withdrawal and found some graves in the German territory. These were opened, and ammunition boxes containing 5,000 rounds were found, but no bodies were in the graves. It was obvious that the enemy intended to return. More defense trenches were dug at Saisi, and a fence of felled thorn trees was placed beyond the trenches. Hodson, who had overall command of British and Belgian troops in northern Rhodesia, now moved to Fife with one officer, 30 NRP soldiers, and 10 volunteers. O'Sullivan was placed in command of Saisi. The BSAP 7-pounder gun was a British 2.5-inch mountain gun, which was jointed between the breech and the muzzle to split the barrel into manageable mule loads. This type of gun was known as a screw gun. The barrel was rifled with 8 grooves with progressive curves, and this meant that a degree of accuracy could be achieved. The BSAP gun team demonstrated this by hitting a German gun on its muzzle and putting it out of action. When the telegraph line to Saisi was cut by the enemy on 25th July, Hodson had ordered a relief force to leave from Abercorn, which was about 50 kilometers far from Saisi. The relief troops were 270 Askari of the Belgian 1st Battalion under Major de Knick, and 50 NRP men under Captain C.H. Fair. On 25th July, the relief force encountered German troops blocking the route north of Saisi, and they engaged them in a fierce fight. This action distracted Wall and drew away some of his troops from the siege. The next day, 34 of the relief troops broke through into the Saisi perimeter. The remainder of the relief force continued to fight Wall's men north of Saisi. On 31st July, Wall invited the Saisi garrison to surrender, but O'Sullivan refused to consider the idea. That evening, around 1,500 enemy troops mounted an attack on the British perimeter supported by heavy fire. But the German field companies and the Arabs declined to charge beyond the outer thorn fence, as the British defensive fire was also heavy. The defenders' trenches were never threatened. The siege continued, but no further attacks were mounted. On 3rd of August, having consumed his supplies, Wall broke off the battle and marched his men away. The Germans were believed to have lost 5 Europeans, and 28 Askari were killed. The Belgians lost 5 Askari, and 3 were wounded. The British had lost one man, 1185 Private Malizani, NRP. A figure for British personnel wounded was not reported. For his gallantry in commanding the defense of Saisi, Captain John Joseph O'Sullivan, NRP, was promoted to Major and awarded a Distinguished Service Order. The Germans made no further attacks into British territory after their withdrawal from Saisi. Raids to secure lengths of telegraph wire continued, however, and the captured telegraph stores were used to run a new German line between New Langenberg, now named Tukuyu, and Iringa. The NRP alone could not have kept the enemy out of northern Rhodesia. Belgian military assistance was quickly delivered and was effective, and the Congolese Askari wanted to fight. Later in the East African campaign, the Belgians invaded GEA on 2 fronts, and also supplied troops to be landed on the southeastern coast of GEA, as well as providing battalions to pursue Naaman's raid into northeastern GEA. Belgium deserves more recognition for the military contribution she made in the Great War East African campaign. A change in direction on the northern border came when Brigadier General Edward Northey was appointed to command the Nyasaland Rhodesia Field Force. Up to this point in time, the Northern Rhodesia and the Nyasaland forces had not been communicating with each other effectively or coordinating military action. Northey's arrival heralded a new intent to apply professional military procedures prior to a British invasion of southern German East Africa. In January 1916, Lieutenant Colonel Harry March Stennett, Northern Rhodesia Police, was awarded a Distinguished Service Order. All the Allied troops who died were buried where they fell. After the war, the British European dead were reburied in a Commonwealth War Graves Commission plot in Ndola Kansenshi Cemetery. The African dead of the Northern Rhodesia Police are commemorated by name on the Livingston Camp Memorial. Unnamed and unknown Northern Rhodesian porters who died are commemorated by the Abercorn Memorial. All these locations are in Zambia.